Ever since the first probes flew by to Mars, images have fired the human imagination. In the 1970s, photographs like the Mars face caused a sensation. Later, it turned out that all the shapes reminiscent of faces, buildings, or traces of living creatures are nothing more than an optical illusion. Mars research is now much more advanced. We humans have already placed research robots on Mars, and in the next 15 years, rock samples taken on Mars will return to Earth. Meanwhile, the news about strange discoveries on Mars and exciting photographs never stop. Today, we present to you 5 puzzling pictures that were really taken on Mars, as well as their true backgrounds. But before we get started, we'd like to ask you to make a small contribution to our work. If you subscribe to our channel, you can actively contribute to the production of many more exciting videos like this one in the future. If you also activate the notification bell, you're guaranteed to never miss a new post in the future. And of course, we're also very happy with a like if you enjoy the video. We start this pictorial journey with one of the most beautiful and incredible images taken on Mars in the last decade. First Mars coral. This image, much more reminiscent of a terrestrial beach, was actually taken on Mars. It is hard to believe that these delicate lines in the sand and the coral-like structure could be on a dead planet with no life or liquid water, but it is so. The photo was taken by the Mars rover Curiosity, which has been traveling on Mars since August 6, 2012. The wavy lines are caused by Martian winds. However, the coral-like object is demonstrably not a living being, nor is it a fossilization of a plant. With this object, it acts just like the two rock spheres' concretions. As concretion mineralogists designate special forms of the crystal formation of rock of different kind, concretions can be spherical, bulbous, tubular, or even rose-shaped. The coral is a very rare example of a flower-shaped concretion. This find is very special because similar shapes have not been discovered on Mars before. This shape is finally not just an optical illusion, but truly a rare object that can provide cosmogeologists with important clues about mineral processes on Mars. It seems that many strange rock shapes have been discovered on Mars, but most of them were optical illusions. The Martian face, pyramid peaks, the Martian frog, and many other formations turned out to be pareidolia after a closer look. Researchers use this term when the human brain thinks it recognizes clues to familiar things like faces, plants, or buildings in rocks, or other inanimate structures. Curiosity and its successor rover, Perseverance, were specially equipped with sophisticated camera systems that allow panoramic views of rocks and should prevent optical illusions caused by pareidolia in the future. 2. Mars light. This picture could have been taken somewhere on the prairies of the Wild West, where a lone rider spots the familiar light of home in the distance and looks forward to going home. But this picture was also taken on Mars. When NASA's Curiosity rover radioed this image to Earth on April 3, 2014, scientists were amazed. A single light source of this size should not actually exist on Mars. The location from which the light emanated was quickly checked. After all, it could not be ruled out that the reflection was caused by minerals or even a crashed Mars probe. When all natural and known sources could be ruled out as the origin of the light, the researchers were left to guess. They settled on a rare and hitherto unknown phenomenon that was most likely caused by cosmic rays. 3. What's that glittering in the sand? This image didn't seem all that strange or exciting at first, until one of the scientists on Earth noticed a slight glint in the Martian sand. Thanks to high-resolution cameras, the glint was made visible at extreme magnification. The image caused great astonishment. No researcher had ever seen anything like it on Mars, and no one could explain what the glitter snippet was. The discovery kept researchers on tenterhooks for several days in 2012. Because Curiosity is equipped with long gripper arms, it was possible for NASA's rover to pick up the odd piece and hold it closer to the cameras. After long deliberations, scientists grudgingly concluded that this part was most likely plastic that Curiosity itself had lost. What made the researchers uneasy was the fact that pieces of Curiosity's hardware appeared to be coming loose. The part had plopped down just after the 61st day of Curiosity's mission. Today, the rover has been in service for 10 more years, and time showed that the snippet's loss could not have been a bad thing. Of course, people on Earth were also concerned about the rover's environmental footprint. The fact that our probes leave trash on the red planet is disliked by some scientists, even if the planet is not inhabited. 4. Gray Rock. Curiosity and Perseverance are the first Mars rovers that can analyze rock samples. They use two methods to do this. They grab some rock, dust, or sand with their arms and hold it close to the camera so researchers on Earth can get a really close look. Geologists can usually tell very well what the sample is by its color, how it trickles, or even how it reflects light. For even more precise analyses, the rovers point a laser at the rock. The reflected light beam is then read by the chemistry and camera instrument on board the rovers. In 2012, Curiosity became the first rover ever to drill into the surface of Mars, and this grayish rock came to light. This was an exciting moment for researchers because rocks on Mars are normally always orange, beige, or reddish. On Mars, the colors come from oxidation processes of the iron contained in the rock. Scientists hope to use the gray coloration, mineralogy, and chemistry of the rock powder to gain insights into the geological history and composition of Mars. Geological data can be used to draw further conclusions about the planet's past. Evidence of once wet environments and major water deposits may even be found. The rusting process and the reddish colors already show that there must have been humidity on today's dust-dry surface not so long ago. 5. Mars Henge. In 2015, the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter photographed from space this stone formation on the surface of Mars. The stone circle is apparently elevated on a hill and has an amazing geometry. Again, all coincidence? Or could these stones have once been placed there by living creatures? The formation quickly got the name Mars Henge and caused speculations all over the world. Just 2 years later, Curiosity photographed this formation. The July 2017 image shows a near-perfect circle and is quite different from the Mars craters that can be attributed to natural phenomena. Similar to Mars Henge, it also looks like these stone blocks were intentionally placed in this circular structure. Mars geologists actually suspect that the circle is just the tip of a much larger structure below. However, it will be at least a few decades before humans or robots will be able to conduct large-scale investigations or even excavations on Mars. All in all, the researchers think that this is also pareidolia. We want to see in the randomly arranged stones something made by living beings, because our brains are programmed that way, and the ideas of living beings on Mars are firmly anchored in our minds. The belief that Mars was a populated neighboring planet emerged as early as the late Middle Ages. When the Italian astronomer Cassini discovered the Martian gullies, he assumed that these were river courses. Color changes on the Martian surface looked from a distance like our seasons on Earth. The idea of the Martian was taken up several times in science fiction novels toward the end of the 19th century. On July 15, 1965, the first probe reached Mars. Mariner 4 delivered images that no one had expected. Instead of oceans, rivers, lakes, or even settlements, Mars provided impressions of a rather barren surface with craters, deserts, and some mountains. But there was no trace of life. In the coming decades, the image of a dust-dry and dead Mars became increasingly clear. People on Earth and scientists didn't quite know whether to be disappointed or reassured. A neighboring planet with a warlike population, much like the Martians were often portrayed in movies and books, would certainly have caused us more headaches than a completely inanimate world. Researchers have long since given up the search for existing life on Mars. Now it's really just a matter of finding out if life once existed on Mars. Computer simulations showed that Mars very likely had an atmosphere until a few million years ago. Life-friendly conditions could have prevailed under this atmosphere. It cannot be completely ruled out that life existed several million years ago, which then disappeared due to environmental catastrophes or the loss of the atmosphere. We too are in the process of destroying our atmosphere, and scientists are looking with horror at Mars. Could Earth look like this in a few thousand or million years? And would our buildings, monuments, or landscapes then also be hidden under a thick layer of rock and dust? These are precisely the questions that researchers would like to answer. For this reason, around 6 international probes and rovers are currently positioned on and around Mars. In addition to NASA's rovers and probes, more and more space novices are sending explorers to Mars. In 2021, China's first Mars rover, Zhurong, landed on the red planet. Zhurong moved faster than any other rover and is said to have even found evidence of former water deposits along its 2-kilometer route. China is currently withholding its findings, however. Last year, rumors surfaced that the rover, which was powered by solar sails, was no longer operational. The Chinese side did not comment further on the claims. India has also come close to the red planet with the Mars Orbiter mission, and even some super-rich sheikhs from the United Arab Emirates are said to have Mars projects in the pipeline. So we can be curious which new surprising, bizarre, exciting, or just unique pictures will reach us soon from Mars. Tell us now which of these images you liked best and how you feel about Mars exploration. We welcome your contributions and your discussions on the topic in the comments. We'll see you next time on Simply Space.